that diagram of the tax control devices. So here I have the transmission line. In front of this, here I have the tax controller. Here I have the tax controller. And here is the basic block diagram. So from the types of tax control devices are the shunt controller, series controller, and the shunt and the series combined controller and the series controller. So here first we are going to see the static or compensator and the second thyristor control series compensator and the third one is the STATCOM, fourth one is the UPFC unified power flow controller. So these tax control devices are used for regulating the voltage in a power system under a transient condition. So here having the shunt and the series methods is first we are going to see the static power compensator. This static power compensator is the shunt control devices. So this is the transmission line and here having the thyristor control rectifier and the thyristor capacitor controllers are used in the static power compensator. In static power compensator here we are using the thyristor control rectifier and the thyristor control capacitor, okay, on the fixed capacitor and the filters. Now this static power compensator is useful to regulating the voltage of the sending end side to receiving end side for regulating the voltage. Here I am having the transformer, three phase transformer, and from the transmission line is connected to the shunt connections. After it is connected to the number of TCR and number of TCC, that is the thyristor control rectifier and thyristor capacitor control. And again having the fixed capacitor and the filters. So here the static power compensator are used under the power electronics devices. So power electronics devices we are used to using the thyristors and the diodes. From this controller we are using the thyristor and the capacitor in the bidirectional system. So whenever the system having in transient, they are having automatically it's getting to be a voltage regulation. From this here taking the feedback from this thyristor switch. So this is a static devices, that is known as the static power compensator. So next we move to the thyristor control series compensator. This thyristor series compensator is a series controller. So because here I have the transmission line, this transmission line is connected to the series capacitor by 1 by 1. In the capacitor, series capacitor, connected to the thyristor control rectifier. This thyristor control rectifier is used to regulating the voltage under the transient condition. So this thyristor control is the series compensator. Under the transient condition in the power system, this TCR is acting as a voltage regulator and regulating the transient to the steady state condition. Next, STATCOM. So STATCOM is a power electronics devices. We are using the three phases thyristor control rectifiers and also here I will use the end of the capacitor. So from this here I have the three phases, phase R, phase Y phase and B phase. Connected to example for the rectifier, three phase rectifier inverter. So this concept of the thyristor control rectifier connected to the each and every phases. So tax control devices, STATCOM. So STATCOM is a shunt controller rectifier because here I am in the line, and the lines are connected by shunt. From here I have the three phase lines and here are using the six thyristor control rectifiers. And this end of this capacitor is here used by helping of this charging. Here using the STATCOM. STATCOM is a here whenever in the real power and reactive power of a transmission, that is the reactive power, this STATCOM will help to having so real power. Whenever there is this transient power in the transmission line, this STATCOM help to regulating the automatically regulating the voltage to the receiving end side and the common side, it is act as a steady state stability. So here this STATCOM is under the power electronic devices, diodes and thyristors commons are used in this STATCOM. This STATCOM here having the three phase lines, each and every line here having the power electronic devices and controllers. the help of the microprocessor or microcontroller, PMW controllers. Whenever here, that is the transient state, this capacitor, before that, the capacitor will be taken as charges. Whenever it is a transient state, this capacitor will be discharged from this with the help of the thyristor control rectifier and discharge into the line. So this transient power will be regulated as a steady state constant. So next, unified power flow controller. This unified power flow controller is a both series and shunt controller connections. It is a bidirectional operation and also it is a series and a shunt controller. Here this connection, this one is a transmission line connection, and here this one is a series connection, this is a shunt connection. So this is a shunt connected control rectifier, this is a series connected control rectifier. Here transformer is connected in the series, this transformer is connected in the shunt. This control rectifiers, these are used, these are whatever, these are fax controllers like STATCOM, static wall compensator, thyristor control switched rectifiers. And in between this two rectifiers, we connect the DC link for the feedback system. Whenever in the transient system of a power system, it acts as the voltage regulation automatically and compensate the voltage in the receiving end side. So this is a unified power flow controller. This is the main application, is the in the transmission and the distribution. It is a regulating the voltage from the transient state to the normal steady state voltage. Thank you.